Good morning, students.
In continuation of the polynomial, this is the second part. In the previous video, I have discussed about the introduction part. Now, I will discuss few questions which is based on this initial part. Now, you should know that zero of the polynomial is also called as root of the polynomial. Zero of the polynomial is also called roots of the polynomial. And when you study about the quadratic equation, that root will become as a solution of the quadratic equation. So all these three are almost same, no differences there. Secondly, the number of zeros depends on the degree of the polynomial. Almost it depends on the degree of the polynomial. Suppose it is 1 degree polynomial, so you can expect 1 zero. If it is 2 degree polynomial, you can expect 2 zero, provided it can be factorized. If it is 3 degree, you can expect 3 zeros, and so on. So few questions which are based on this I will discuss today. Next class we will discuss some another topic, that is what is the related topic, that is called Demeter theorem. But let us discuss few questions. Suppose x is equal to 2x cube minus 3x square plus 4x minus 3, then find p minus half and second p 3. See, px is equal to 2x cube minus 3x square plus 4x minus 3. And in place of x, what is given here? Minus half. That shows that p minus half is equal to 2 into minus half whole cube, 3 into minus half whole square, 4 into minus half minus 3. And then it will be equal to 2 into minus 1 by 8 minus 3 into 1 by 4 minus 2 minus 3, because 2 1 ja 2 2 ja, and so it will be equal to minus 1 by 4 minus 3 by 4 minus 5. How much it is? This is 4 minus 1 minus 3 minus 20, so minus 24 by 4. That is minus 6. Let's check if it is okay or not. Here, 2 1 2 4 ja minus 1 by 4 minus 3 by 4, isn't it? And here is minus 5. So 4 is LCM, minus 1 minus 3 minus 20, and that will be equal to how much? Minus 24 minus 6. If you want to find out 3, how can you? Same way you can go. P 3, 2 into my 3 whole cube, 3 into 3 whole square, 4 into 3 minus 3. 3 3 is 9, 3 is 27, 9 3 is 27, 12 minus 3, 54 minus 27 plus 9, 27 plus 9. 36. So this is the answer. So it is a very simple, it can be asked one mark question to just make you understand the concept of the polynomial. Now let us discuss another question. find the zeros of fx is equal to x cube minus 6x square plus 11x minus 6. In order to find out the zeros, you look at here what to do. You please see this constant. What is the constant? 6. What are possible factors of 6 that you have to collect? And you have to collect in both. That's why I have used to say here possible factors. Possible factor means you have to take positive value as well as negative value. So we can say plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, plus minus 6. 1 by 1 we will substitute here and you will see which of the factor is making here 0. Now, since here 3 degree, so I will expect 3 zeros. And I will give you the easiest way how to find out the zeros. So first you put it 1. When you put it 1, this will be 1 minus 6 plus 11 minus 6. So minus 6 minus 6 minus 12, 1 plus 11 is 12. So 12 minus 12, 0. 12 minus 12, 0. So you will write here. Then x is equal to 1, then fx is equal to 0. When you say x is equal to 1, so x is equal to 1, so when you brought it this side, then x minus 1 is equal to 0. That means this becomes the factor. When the remainder is 0, when it is a factor. So that's why it is considered as the dividend. It is considered as the, therefore, we can say x minus 1 is the factor of fx. So this is one of the factor. So consider as this is a dividend and this is a divide. Sorry, this is a divisor and this is a dividend. You divide and the quotient will be in a quadratic polynomial which you can easily factorize by using the Middle-Lebesgue splitting form. So you just divide x minus 1. And this is x cube minus 6x square plus 11x minus 6. How much it is? X square, x cube minus x square minus plus cancel minus 5x square plus 11x minus 6 minus 5x minus 5x square minus minus plus 5x positive negative cancel 6x minus 6 plus 6. 6x minus 6 minus minus cancel. So therefore fx is what? This is called fx. Can be written as x minus 1 into x square minus 5x plus 6 plus 0. What I have done? I have written the formula dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So it has no value at all. So what shall we do? You can take it. Fx is equal to x minus 1 into x square minus 5x plus 6, x minus 1 into x square minus 3x minus 2x plus 6, x minus 1 into x common x minus 3 minus 2 common x minus 3, and then x minus 1 into x minus 2 into x minus 3. And as I said, as soon as you find the factors of the given polynomial, what would you do? You will take each of the factor as 0. So if x minus 1 is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to 1. If x minus 2 is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to 2. If x minus 3 is equal to 0, therefore x is equal to 3. So zeros are 1, 2, 3. So these are the zeros of this given polynomial. Now let us say one more. If x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1 are roots of fx is equal to 2 x cube minus 3x square plus ax plus b, then find A and B. Remember, here is a very good question. If I say x equal to 0 and x equal to 1 are roots, roots means these are the zeros. And when we say that x is equal to 0 is a root of this equation, is this polynomial, means we can have the remainder will be 0. So, since x is equal to 0 is one of the root of fx, then fx is equal to 2x cube minus 3x square plus ax plus b, and fx means f0 is equal to 2 into 0 minus 3 into 0 plus a into 0 plus b, and this will be also equal to 0. That is what is called remainder theorem. By remainder theorem, this will be 0, I will tell you later on. But you just take it, whichever the factor is coming, whichever the root is coming 0, its polynomial at the LHS will be 0. So that will be 0 minus 0 plus 0 plus b, and therefore b is also equal to 0. Because b or a, you can't find out unless or until you have the value of LHS as 0 or any other value. Secondly, since x is equal to 1 is the root of fx, therefore we can say f1 is equal to 2 into 1 cube, 3 into 1 square, a into 1 plus b. Again, this is also equal to 0 because it is the 0, it is the root. So this is 0, and then 2 minus 3 plus a plus b. B, you have already got 0, so 0 is equal to minus 1 plus a plus 0, and therefore a is equal to 1. So what are the values of a and b? A is equal to 1, a is equal to 0. So these are the few questions which I wish to discuss in the same polynomial. Next class, some more question on this I will discuss, and then only I will come to the remainder theorem. Thank you so much.